Boom. Welcome to the RTM Podcast Show, episode 7. Big Bad Spray, Young Spray, here with my co-host.
Hi, everyone.
Queen Ice Cream. You already know today, got the special guest, Miss Terry Walker.
Hey.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, you lot might not know Terry, but I know Terry. But basically, this show as well, like I said from episode 1, it's like aimed at kind of my era, innit? So it's like Terry is very big in my era. So we're all about giving people their flowers whilst they're alive, you know?
Like, definitely.
Because a lot of people, we feel like, have gone without their flowers and, you know, they deserve it whilst they're alive, not just putting over their grief. So, yeah, Miss Terry.
Oh, thank you for having me, guys. I'm actually really excited. COVID, obviously, no one's seen each other, but thank you for having me. I'm excited.
We're excited to have you. First of all, obviously, I just want to thank everyone for the support, all the comments, positive, negative, whatever. It's all good. And thanks to those that donated as well, I just want to say, because obviously, I didn't stress it last time, but we got the PayPal and the Cash App. For any donations, because obviously we're just here, we're just doing this ourselves, whatever, we pay for it. Need to pay Cream before Red Skull's mad, you get what I'm saying? So, but yeah, back to the interview. Yes. Terry, boom now.
Boom now.
Your name ain't even Terry.
Stop trying to bait me up.
you made me do my research. And
I did.
So,
yes.
What happened there? Because I know you as Terry Walker.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Nice little Terry Walker when you started, whatever. I want to give you diggings. But that was... That was long time ago.
Never happened, by the way.
Obviously. Never happened. But
it's great.
You could have got it back then. You got the same. You had the weave and that. I'm not really one for the short hair thing.
I know, but I shaved it off you.
I told you already, I'm not one for the short hair thing.
No, but you've always been a hottie though.
Hey, what though?
Yeah, definitely.
Hey, what though? Chanel. Chanel.
Oh.
What's Chanel now?
What's Chanel?
Yeah, what's Chanel now? Where did that come from? Talk us through. Where was you born? Talk us through your...
I was born in England, in Wimbledon, darling.
Wimbledon, okay.
But my family's all from South, innit? But when I was 4 years old, I moved to Germany.
Oh, really?
My mum married a German guy, and I moved there from the age of four until I was 18.
Okay.
But then my stepdad, he adopted me and he gave me his surname, so hence why my name is Chanel Gstettenbauer.
I didn't know how to pronounce it. It sounded like a machine, though. I just do. When I read it, it's like Gettenbauer or something. It sounded like a machine.
You've actually got in the most right. Gstettenbauer.
Okay, nice. It sounded like a machine.
Gstettenbauer.
See, everyone gets it wrong. It's the Gstetten.
But you know what?
Apparently, I've got German in me.
Because can it make sense? You can see you've got a
I was younger, when I was younger in primary school as well, my sister knows, like we went to school as like, I swear I was like Leon Daniels or something. See, like when you're young, you don't know what your mum's doing. You don't know what's going on and they don't tell you nothing.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? But so you had a next surname now.
Yeah,
so. Chanel getting, I'm thinking, is this? But yeah, it's you, so.
Yeah, and the thing is, I've always spoken about it. That's the thing. Only if I think until people do their research and understand what it is, they'll know. But of course you'd know me as Terry Walker because you knew me through the music industry. Mm. But the Gstettenbauer name, and that was one of them things where the Walker is actually my real dad's name, my biological father. Mm. But obviously when my stepdad adopted me, like he became my dad, innit? So as far as I'm concerned, he was there, innit? Not saying that my dad wasn't like that, but it's like it's a different relationship. Mm-hmm. But then to pay homage to my dad, because I really started singing at his when he passed away, and I was about 18. Mm. So I thought Terry Walker. The reason Terry, because I used to love Toni Braxton and that whole short hair, you know, that whole being a kind of, I was quite tomboyish. I still kind of am a little bit, you know, that's why hence the whole short hair thing. And so I thought, Toni, Terry, you know.
Toni Braxton.
Yeah. Do you remember her first album? She had the short hair and the leather jacket on. I remember thinking.
So you just picked Terry, you just wanted a different name?
Yeah, at the time, we just thought Chanel, like, because the kind of music that I made...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Chanel's.
At the time, there was a lot of Chanel's. So remember, my mum's generation, everyone was called either Mercedes or Chanel. Remember, everything was about fashion, innit? It was all about the designer stuff, innit? But when I started doing my music, my stuff was very old school and kind of a bit classic. So I just thought Chanel just didn't sound like the music that I was making. So I thought Terry Walker. So every time when people meet me, they either think I'm a guy or they think I'm some old woman, innit? Then they meet me like, oh.
So how was Germany tough?
Oh, do you know what? For me,
you could talk fluent German.
Yeah,
right?
I spoke fluent some Deutsch.
Okay. Yeah. Well, yeah. Height, whatever.
That, why does everyone always do that?
I don't know what to say.
Everyone goes high, high. They always do that.
How long was you there for?
From the age of 4 until I was 18.
Okay.
So it's for 14 years. My first time, I've got a song called in German, actually, called Deutschland. But
How was Germany?
Germany,
like, racist. Like?
See, this is the thing. Everyone says that I had one racist experience in Germany growing up. It was some old woman, like still from the probably Nazi days, going to me. Oh, you nigger, innit? Like, that's the one time. But otherwise, what I saw over there is how much we influence as Black people, as just people from different cultures. They embraced it, maybe because they were felt so guilty about what happened back in the day with Hitler, whatever. They embrace culture so much. They love reggae. They love soul. They love hip hop.
You know what though? See the Hitler thing. All right, cool.
And he's from Austria.
Hitler's a madman, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. But he went out for the Black people still. So
wasn't he?
Was he? I didn't know.
I think anyone that didn't have blue eyes and had blonde hair. Yeah. He was just. And the thing is, he had brown hair and brown eyes.
Black people was cool still, but. And how
was school out there?
For me, Black people was alright.
I'm not gonna lie, school for me, I was a bit destructive when I was over there because I think I was going through a phase where I didn't necessarily understand my identity that much. So I just wanted to be out and party. So I ended up coming back to England to go to school at boarding schools. My mum back then was bad girl doing her thing. You get me? So I ended up going to So she ended up going. She ended up sending me to boarding school, but I was still living in Germany. So my school experience is definitely more English because at one point I couldn't even speak English properly because my German, I was, because when you're 4 years old, yeah. Because everyone, when I came back to England, everyone was like, oh, you're so German, oh, you're so white, you're this, you're that. And I had to kind of find my way back to understanding where I came from. So, but that whole experience for me has been the best thing because it's made me understand how we are seen across, not just here, but just in the world. Do you get me? Yeah. So, yeah.
Mm. So, like, what was your favourite? It's alright. I don't mind catching COVID.
No, it's not COVID.
It's alright. I don't mind catching COVID.
It's not COVID. You know, it's mucus. Shut up.
It's alright. It's only a flu.
It's not
I've been
flu.
Saying for episodes.
I had
it's
a test the other day. I'm negative. So
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Negative is a very good word.
But I'm not a good word, kids.
Negative is a very good word. But
you know, I can't really. Anyway, go on.
No, but what's your favorite memory, like in Germany?
My favourite memory is seeing how my mum would run shit, like, as a Black woman, like, boss, and everyone, like, she would, because we did the different things that, like, Black businesses that she owned, and how she would just encourage women, not just Black women, but just women in general, just to boss up. So, and then being in a country that is not necessarily where we come from, do you know what I mean? And just seeing that. So, everywhere we went, if we went out somewhere, and I'd be like, oh, no, you're Carol's daughter, you're Gustenberg's daughter, you know what I mean? But then, obviously, then me becoming my own person. So then come back over here, all of that obviously went because no one knew about that. So I had to kind of, but then what will happen is because of that confidence I had from seeing that, wherever I went, I didn't care if people didn't know who I was. The confidence was just instilled in me because I saw, I was raised by bosses, innit? So,
right.
Yeah,
so
it's for the same thing I was saying with my team.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Where I was brought up, the class I was in was way above to when I came here.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Oh, yeah, because right. In the Caribbean, innit?
Right.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? So come from a different class to come to just be normal. But yeah, so I get that. So that was your best, your favourite memory. Was the racist thing your worst memory or is there something even worse than that?
No, do you know, God, no. No, to be honest with you, I think I'm one of the people that I wake up happy until someone pisses me off.
Well, so that's a very good way to look at life because the main topic today is energy. That's a good way to have. But so when did you start your music career then?
Well, this is the thing.
Because I saw you started opera and all that. And I thought, what, opera?
Yeah, when did you find out you could sing?
Well, this is the thing. I could at first, you know, like my mum's Jamaican. So when I was trying to be like, shut up, Emma, I didn't make up too much damn noise in the fucking house. Be quiet, shut up. That's all I used to hear all the time. Because I was practicing, because I was listening to Whitney Houston, and I'd hear Lauren, I'd hear Aretha, and I'm like, I want to sing like these people. Mm-hmm. But I sounded nothing like them. Like, I was getting it wrong. I didn't even know how to riff or anything. So obviously from a young age, I heard music and I was like, I want to make people feel the way that they're making me feel. That's what I remember thinking.
Yeah.
So when I went to boarding school, the only way that I could have singing lessons was by having opera lessons. So I had opera lessons, and but my teacher, she used to get so pissed off because she's like, oh, I don't want you to sing that secular music because opera music is, you could travel the world and it's different because you're Black and not many, there's not many Black opera singers.
Mm.
I said, nah, man, my soul's just not in it. But what it gave me was, you know, like when you're an athlete and the training, like when you have to warm up, and it gave me the best vocal techniques. Whatever stage I'm on, I know how to project my voice. I know how to command the stage, and because you have to command it differently.
In opera, like you have different levels, like a highest.
Yeah,
like
you got octave, like you got alto. The thing is, because of it, I actually had most of them, but I think when I started doing certain things, drinking and smoking, certain octaves disappeared. Yeah. But and then obviously just kind of like distressing your voice, because when I wanted to sing like a certain singers, I felt like I had to roughen it a bit. So I'd, you know, shout. And but then when you find your voice and you can know how to kind of alternate in between the soprano and your head voice into your, you know,
your voice is sick, man.
Yeah. Oh my God, a compliment. Your voice is sick.
No, but you know what, because I was even saying the cream, I was saying like, all right, cool. In the UK, my four best singer voices, I don't know, with my era anyway, would be you, Mutya.
I love Mutya's voice. I love her, man. And her energy as well.
Amy Winehouse.
Come on.
And Adele.
Adele,
he said,
yeah.
What?
Yeah.
I'm all over the place.
No, but that's the voices, isn't it? I can't, well,
there is think others. Of any, yeah, there's loads. There is others think as it. Well. Maybe
but that's hate, my four, innit? Well, and you know, you tell me if there's others.
Yeah, no, there is.
Go on.
I think like Beverly Knight.
Beverly Knight.
Oh, yeah. Alexandra Burke.
No, but that's,
Leona Lewis. You know,
so there are people not really I hate my when era, I get put on the spot. Alexandra Burke and Leona Lewis.
They came a bit after, but
I'm talking like just after R&B. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, like when you lot were still kind of being soulful.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? Shola can...
Karen Wheeler from Soul to Soul.
Shola can be in that era.
Oh my gosh. Come on, definitely Anderson. She's there, definitely. Sade. Definitely.
Now, Shola's voice,
do you know the funny thing is with Amy Winehouse? Because before I dropped, like, my album was the one that, it, like, came out before hers, and she'd always come up to me, like, because she was a big fan of what I feel like most deaf, she was in love with him. And obviously, I had him as my first feature.
That's what I was even going to get to.
So when she saw it, she was like, oh my God. But then my album for her, she was like, oh my God. She'd see me, she'd be like, oh my God, I'm such a big fan. And then obviously, she blew up after. Mm. And one thing, every time when she blew up, she would have interviews and she'd be like, why don't people talk about Terry Walker? Why don't people talk about Misha Paris?
Yeah.
Why, and, that's one thing that's the love about her, because she was always like, listen, I'm here because I was inspired by these people. One of the best people, the realest people you'll ever meet. Rest in peace, Amy. I love her.
Aww.
So when you say that, it's a big compliment to me, because
Amy's proper, man. Yeah. I felt her pain in it.
Definitely.
Yeah. You can feel her
She's
pain.
A real one. She's real.
A nitty though, but I could, you get what I'm you saying? Could I feel could feel her movie pain.
You know the thing is, she couldn't lie in it, so she couldn't be around the bullshit. And I think that's why in the end it got... Because I think even her getting to the point that she got to, and no one was saying it, and they were still papping her, and I'm like, this girl needs healing. Let her get back to normal first so she can come back proper.
A voice was a gift.
Oh, such a gift. And her energy and her vibe, like, oh.
But yeah, like, so what happened, like, how did you even get to that Most Def team? Because that Most Def team was big still, but how did, what happened to change you from the opera to doing...
So after I left boarding school, obviously I decided to kind of just, I went to Tele Conti, which is like a performing arts school, which just wasn't for me. Because every time we'd go to like to lunch or something, it would turn into Fame. Everyone would be like, Fame! I'm like, no, this is not who I am. Everyone would start dancing in the streets and stuff. I'm like, I love it. It's a vibe for them, but I'm not that kind of artist. Yeah, I'm like, I'm one of those, I'm a real person. Real life inspires me. So even if I'm drunk today or I'm sober or another day and I'm... everything about me, I embrace all the parts of me. So I'm one of the people that I own myself. So when that's I do good. Wrong and I do right,
that's good.
I don't pretend that I'm not, you know, perfect. Yeah. So when you go to those kind of places, you have to always be on point. You've always got to be that, you know, and I'm not always on point, I'll be honest. But when I'm ready to do what I need to do, I do it. So when I started doing my music, I understood that I wanted to change the narrative of what it means to be a black woman in the industry. So not just being a soul singer, because if the first thing they do, you're a soul singer.
Yeah.
And I know, yes, I can do the soul thing, but I do garage, I do drum and bass, I can do opera, I can do different things, innit? So what I did throughout that journey then, basically, I started just doing different projects to different people. The first one was with TNT. Do you know Gifford?
Yeah.
He passed away. I had a song called Easy Loving You. Then we did Easy Love and I don't even know it. It's like one of those underground records.
I think that one went over my
head. Yeah, you probably wouldn't.
I think that one went over my head still.
But some people know it, you don't, innit? Fucking rude. Anyway. but to be fair, when I did it then times, because obviously I come up from Germany, so I didn't understand this whole garage, because I did the record and people do remixes of it. So I didn't know that in that whole world that people even knew my name. I thought I was just a soul person. So now I find out after, like, people like, when people like Target, like, yeah, no, we had that record, you know, I'm like, huh? Mm. And people, I knew that people like maybe even like Wiley, whatever, they'd know my name. Like, how you, even you, like, how do you know me? Like, how? I don't do the music that you do.
No, so but you knew about us though.
No,
North Star, don't.
Yeah, no, but of course, how could you not know about you?
Clint, Clint said Wagwan though. Shit, I forgot to tell
I'll
you.
I'll tell him hi.
Yeah, he said Wagwan. Yeah. He,
no, but I did. Cause remember, I met you in Mauritius one time.
Come on, man.
He's trying to. He gave me your CD. I still got it at home.
Obviously.
Like, yo, here's my CD. Will you see it? I was like, I was like, excuse cool. me, hello.
Come on, man.
No, but that was years ago, and we was we was in the thing, and I remember you going, yeah, because I'm a rapper, no, 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 North Star. I was like, oh, okay. But obviously, remember, my family's from South, innit? So my brother's Colin. We used to know all Mac and, like, from the whole solid.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, well, it's still one. Still one, so. But I'm just the... When I went to Germany, I just turned into the different quirky... I turned into the quirky hood side, you get me?
So, how did you get to that point where you thought, all right, I'm going to take music seriously, I want to get signed? Because you ended up getting signed by a major.
Do you know what? It's funny, because... Before all of that, I was here and I was trying to find my way, and I did end up doing the whole Shags of People thing. And you know, they did Sweet Like Chocolate, but I didn't sing Sweet Like Chocolate. I sang the rest of all the other songs on the album. I sang a song called Sing Along, which went to number 12 on the charts. I did Top of the Pops, all of that.
Well, you sang Crazy Teacher's song, yeah? Crazy's got a new sing along.
Crazy's got a new sing along. If you want, you can sing along. When I'm on the radio, you can sing along. When I'm on a stage show, you can sing along. Crazy's got a new sing along. If you want, you can sing along.
No, I'm joking.
I do like
Chris. That's the proper sing along, though.
I'm the proper sing along.
That's the proper sing along. Free crazy, though.
But so when I did that, so I had this management team who, bless them, like, they were the first people that introduced me to people like Omar, Donnie, and that world. But again, they didn't really know what to do with me. So I ended up just going to the States for a week because I seemed to clear my head. End up meeting these people, staying out there for a month, and I end up recording this song called Loveful, which then became the record that made me get my deal with Def Jam UK.
Okay.
But because I could, you know how we are. People taking too long to do what they're doing. We get up and just go and do it ourselves. And every time I've done that is when things work out for me. Like, when I'm waiting on people to do things, it never works for me. So just stop waiting on people, innit? So that's what happened. And so that's when I got the Def Jam situation. And the most Def happened because someone actually that knew my dad was like, because it was meant to be either Common or Most Def that was meant to be in that record. And it ended up being Most Def. And every time I see him, he goes, oh, that's one of my favourite records. I'm like, you lie. That's
Mind games.
I didn't believe him either. Like,
why did he come to the video?
No, because no, to be fair, that's my fault. At the time, I was I was dating this guy at the time. And I was on holiday. And then he was supposed to come. And I was supposed to go fly back to New York to be in the studio with him while we recorded the record. But I was like, I'm my boyfriend. I can't leave a holiday. I can't. Now, in hindsight, I'm like, what are you doing? Of course you fucking have to go. Like,
yeah, your boyfriend had you on smash.
No, and then ended up breaking up on you and cheating on me, bastard. Anyway, so.
Mad move.
Yeah. But when you're young, you think you know, innit? Like, I need to fly back. And also, them times I wasn't a hip-hop person like that. I was more into my soul, so. I like, yeah, Most Def, yeah, that's nice, thank you. But now I'm like, are you mad? But Most Def is one of the best artists ever. So influential.
He's lyrical.
Real. And so ahead of his time.
Yeah.
As a female, did your relationships get in the way of your you being an artist?
Do you know what? I realised the person that I was dating at the time, he was also an artist. But I found that, like, because the way...
Who is he?
No, I'll let you know.
Might as well ask. No, mad artist.
But
crazy artist. If he's someone I don't know, mad artist. But go on.
But the thing is, what it was, I realised at the time when things weren't going well for them, but it was starting to, because that's when I was getting the Jules Holland, I was doing Glastonbury, I was doing everything. Like, when I got signed, I was doing
Jules Holland before everyone. But remember, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, they try and forget
and even though you mentioned Top of the Pops, we didn't even mention that. Like, you. Being on on Top of the Pops. That's big.
But you have to understand, remember, we're in a day now, we're in social media days where you can, you kind of narrate your own story. Back then, we were under the influence of other people telling our story. So now, I can tell you bare things that I've done. People will never know, but remember, they want us to be seen how they want us to be seen back then. And now it's like we've been doing this. So.
As far as they're concerned, this industry started about
three years ago. It's crazy, right? So, but it's fine though. I want to give everyone their props because
I love the industry now. I love everything what's going on now. But I just need them to know that
didn't start.
Who played a big part in America?
They always celebrate each other. Right? You know what I mean?
It's a whole industry. They talk about it from the start to the finish. They don't miss out KRS-One.
Yeah, yes.
They don't miss out.
I love this conversation.
What's that?
Africa Bambaataa.
They don't miss out.
No, they don't miss out. And everyone matters.
Exactly.
You know. So it's like, but that's the only thing I would say with this industry is like. They like to forget in it, and maybe we need to look at who's in charge of all these things.
Who's
in charge of feeding out all this information? Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, start feeding out the right information.
Because when you're pioneers in the game, you do a lot of the heavy lifting, you know?
You do.
To make it easier for the ones to come after you. So the ones that come after, when they realise that it's so easy, they need to, like, look before.
And then don't you find that when they make it easy, their music, and not saying judging anyone, but I find that after a while their music becomes nothing because they're not really understanding that there needs to be some grit in it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, because now you're just making music just to feed the fans.
See, they got a thing where you say, don't let them trick you out of your position, yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you know what it is now? A lot of people are tricking themselves into a position.
Yeah, yo!
You get what I'm saying?
I'm loving this conversation!
They're tricking themselves into a position. So it's like... It's like you're not gonna be a Young Spree.
Yeah.
You're not gonna be a Giggs. You're not gonna be a Devious. You're not gonna be a Blade. You're not gonna be a Jaja Saucy. You're not like. But then you got some people that will trick themselves into thinking you're gonna be in there. Yeah. You're not gonna be a Terry Walker. You're not gonna be a Lisa Mafia.
Yeah, no, because I've seen you doing your.
You get what I'm trying to say? Like, there's people what come beforehand.
Yeah.
You get what I'm trying to say? So it's like I'm about showing you know. Just appreciation and respect.
I love
you even to the youth them as well.
Yeah.
Everyone that's doing their thing,
I rate them all highly. Like, they inspire me every day because it makes me realize, yo, I could do more.
I got my favorites. I'm what do they call me? I'm a Peter Pan or whatever. So yes. I listen to
you
their shit as well. Yeah, come on, I kept the tag on old school too. You get me, you go, boss, Trish Terry.
I like to keep it eclectic. I like to listen to old music, young music, all types.
Yeah. But the thing is, remember, as I said, I've known you before I've known you. And without you, even before you start doing music, you and your sister, I've known, like, I'd see you and I'm like, who are those two? Yeah. You'd know who you know also. So now it made sense that you even getting into this. And look, your style is classic. You can do this in 10 years' time. Mm-hmm. It's still the same with you. Mm-hmm. It's always been a thing of where, because there's a confidence within ourselves when it's like, we're not doing it to try and get, we're confident within ourselves. And I think that era we have, when we started out, there wasn't no likes. You know how many people liked you. You just know that you were dope, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Now, likes determines how good something is.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Or who co-signed you, or who's retweeting your tea.
But you know what it is as well, though, T? Like, see, like they say, numbers don't lie. But see, these days, numbers lie. Numbers lie.
All the time.
Like,
yeah.
In our days, numbers didn't lie.
Didn't lie, yeah. That's true, because
sometimes... See, right now, numbers lie.
Yeah, sometimes they push out.
They lie. They're buying followers, they're buying views, they're buying everything. Everything you can buy.
Yeah. Mm. And obviously, if something is working, a lot of people, that, especially companies that invest in these people, they just look at algorithms and they think, oh, this person's doing well, so they must be good, but not actually taking the time to understand the research of why that person's doing well. But as you said, because of the buying of followers or... Because it's the trend right now.
Yeah.
Because these people that are doing things, they're not actually doing their research to understand how this person got here.
A lot of people have big machines and teams behind them buying views for them and stuff like that. So numbers definitely do.
And you know what really tells me the difference? What maybe makes me understand is like when you hear songs, like when you hear certain artists that when you play them like in a house rave, like a family rave, and if your music doesn't get played amongst my family and we're dancing to it, that means your music ain't really doing it. As far as I'm concerned, you might be selling millions of records out there, but if I put a record in my house and everyone's not getting up and going, yo, that's my tune, to me, that's not success to me.
Exactly.
That's success to me.
Yeah.
Because that's how we grew up, wasn't it? Yeah. So, and it's like, it's not even about this numbers game. And also what I hate about what they do with the older generation that have the foundation is like, oh, they're has-beens or they're not relevant right now, which is bullshit because...
Definitely.
Again, like, we're that generation, they're not going to try and do anything to make it. Whilst these nowadays... if you're not doing the right thing, oh, you got to go hard or go home. We were like, no, we just work and we do what we need to do and then we, you know, keep it moving. But, but yeah, it's a good conversation.
That major signing, was that your first signing, yeah?
Yeah, and then after, to be honest with you,
So how did you even get to do the track with Mostef? He was big at that time. Still.
Yeah, he's a legend. He's always going to be a legend, no matter how many hits he's got out or not. But at the time, again, it was like management and the label and stuff. But and I think if I didn't have a major label, I don't think that would have ever happened because he would have never known who I was. And the song got written. That song got written for me. Them times I didn't really write. I had a team of people that were writing for me. Mm-hmm. And the thing is, it's funny because I kind of started backwards. Because I had everything, the 11-piece band, everyone was there, whatever you need to do. But I didn't understand how much power I had. I was like, I just want to sing. I'm just happy to be here. Do you know what I mean? And I think that was so unheard of, especially for a black female back then, to do what she wants to do. But I didn't understand that I could actually really do what I wanted to do.
Right.
Without actually understanding that I didn't necessarily need all these people advising too much. I could have just tried to... I think I needed to take control a bit more now, in hindsight. But I'm glad that it went this way because now, once I did realise... Second album, they tried to turn me into this this dead out version of Beyonce. Like, there's a song called Whoopsie Daisy, which. I didn't write, but like, because she was doing well and Jimmy was doing awful. But again, at the time, I thought, this is what I've got to do. This is the labels thing.
I thought that tune was all right.
It's horrible. A lot of people like that tune.
I thought it's all right, still. It's all right.
But that, for me, when I think about
it... Remember, that's what they were putting you out as.
Yeah.
So that's all I could see.
I had the weave, and I was all right, man. You like all that?
The weave, you look a long hair. Like, do you get what I'm saying? The skin cream's dealing with it. Do you get what I'm saying?
But that shows you again, see, that's not who I am, though. Like, and I want to be who I am. I could do that all day long, and it's great. And I love it on everyone else, like, because I did have it.
I love shortcuts as well, man.
But I remember, I see you. I used to do the shortcuts.
I used to kill the shortcuts.
But my point is, and this is my thing, is another representation of us, like, to be successful, there's not only one side of us. We can do whatever we want.
Yeah.
So after the second album, and they started to, literally, from my first album, getting all the critical acclaim and all the Mercury Music Prize Awards and all this shit, because... That didn't sell, but it was, everyone loved it, but it just needed time to grow.
Yeah.
But because it didn't sell, they were like, oh, we need to change the direction. So they changed the direction, which is completely not who I, you know, I was still growing. But then after that, and it flopped in a way, I kind of said to them, you know, just let me go. But a lot of people thought that I got dropped.
Mm.
But I realised that I had to find myself with people that knew me.
You have to go through a lot of stuff to find your feet and see where what is your little niche, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it was after that you started writing.
I started to realise that, like, because before I didn't see myself as a writer, because they kept putting me in writing teams, innit? Like, you need a writer, you need this. When I started doing my own thing, even when I think about T. Williams, the tune that I've done with T. Williams, which is, funny enough, was recorded in the studio, just literally two doors. Yeah? And it's a song that, when I wrote at the time, his brother came to my house and he gave him, like, the backing track, and I heard it, I was like, you're not having that, this is mine, I'm taking this now, yeah? So I wrote it. And I remember writing it, and when I recorded it, I remember thinking, it's going to take a time for people to get it, but when they get it, it's going to hit.
Mm-hmm.
This lockdown, from everyone from Continental G to Super G, everyone's been playing this record. It's been a lockdown song.
Listen.
And I'm like, it's 10 years. It's taken 10 years for it to hit.
But they can't go out, though.
Yeah,
they can't go out of fashion. Like,
they can't get out of fashion.
No, they can't. Those tunes, they stick. Yeah, they stick.
Because, you know, the thing is, when you understand your craft and you understand, like, when the beat drops, when the first lyric comes in and everything. So what I managed to do, I think with me, what I was lucky to do is that I got to experience what it means to be successful, but I got to also experience it by doing me. So the first time when I got, when they tried to make me not be me, that's when I realized this is where it went wrong. Hence why I had to leave, because I think when I was my most successful being on Jules Holland is when I was unapologetic. Yes. That is it.
That's the first album. Yeah.
That's the first album. That's when I got everything. Everyone was like, "Oh my god, who's the table?" The second one. That's when everything.
Doing some big tune on there. I was listening to. Researching.
You
weren't
listening to shit, you liar.
I was researching quickly because obviously they got onto me, innit? They're like, they're moving like, I've got to get better at my madness. Do you get what I'm saying? So I've got to be a better host. So yeah,
you're
I was researching host. And I see like, yeah, there's some tune and then you was talking about, it was just, I can't even remember what it's called. That's how shit I am at a host, yeah.
But, you're not shit.
So no, it's performing the best thing. It's like one of your favourite things about being an artist.
100%. Let me finish though. Sorry. You're saying something. Yeah, you're saying something. Yeah. about like, oh, they don't love you when you don't phone them or something. I'm a madman, so I'm not getting it right, innit? Basically, the way I took it, yeah, it's like, if you just stop phoning people, yeah.
Oh, this is a song called Fake.
It might be. I don't know, but it's like, if you just stop phoning people, yeah.
Yeah.
You realise they don't phone you.
They don't phone you.
100%.
And then you realise they don't even really care.
They don't really rate you, yeah.
You get what I'm trying to say? They don't really care. And that's like one of the tunes, and I thought, rah, like,
that's fake, it's fake from the first album.
It hit home with me, because I'm thinking, rah, like, I just stopped phoning people. And I realised, because my phone stopped ringing.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Because that's it's like me, I check for people a lot. That's how I am.
Yeah, yeah.
I check for people, innit? Well, go on, or phone, because if you care, you phone, innit?
Yeah.
I thought, oh, let me just stop phoning people. My phone stopped ringing.
That happened to me.
You get what I'm saying? My phone stopped ringing.
That happened to me. I stopped ringing because I noticed if I don't phone them,
they don't phone me.
I just needed to get that out of my brain. But
No, but it's funny you said it, because I think at the time, the way I was when I first came up from Germany, especially, this openness, of, especially being a black woman, you remember, you used to us being a bit more like standoffish and like we got to pee. My sister's very much like, she's checking you out before she's warm. Mm. I'm like, hi, everyone, that's me. I come into the room and I hug everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And I was that person in the industry. I was putting everyone on, but I have you got everyone, and I started to realize, oh shit, a lot of people they're drawn to the energy, but when it comes to the other way around, then they're giving it back to me.
No,
the energy, exactly. You know, energy. And I started to realize that, right, and then, as you said, the whole thing of like just fake people, I started to realize there's a lot of people that are not really about what we're about. Like, I come in here straight away, I've heard about you so much, but instantly, and it's funny because I wasn't sure, we could have been like, oh, you might be a bit like, bitch, but you were like, hey, this one, every time I see him, I'm always cussing him, and he's always like, but I've never said, so when you say people talk about, oh, they're scared, or I'm like, I don't get that, I don't understand it, it's weird to me, I don't understand, because then that makes me realize that you don't know yourself. Whoever thinks that way is because of whatever insecurities that you've got going on with you, and I think. Because I think at the end of the day, I think we are so transparent as human beings. I think if you take the time to pay attention to see when a person's acting out, something's going on in it. Why is she doing too much? What's going 100%. On here? Mm. Don't just be like, oh, she's just crazy. There's a reason why she's acting the way she's acting, isn't it? Mm. If you care, you're gonna take the time to listen. If you don't, you're gonna be like, you're just gonna dismiss 100%. It. And this is where I come from. That's where I come from. Just growing up, everyone around me has always been very straightforward about what they see, and that's why I have to extend, isn't it?
Mm.
So, you know.
Yeah, yeah, so how did, like, so after that, the second album, when they tried to change you and you left them and all that, what was your next step like?
After that, I kind of went
How did you stay motivated?
This is the thing, I wake up, listen, my family, we're Jamaicans, come on, hello. We wake up every day, it's like, shut up, we're dancing, we're drinking, we're vibing, that's me.
100%.
I've woken up from growing up in Germany, and I think, so that's never been, like, the thing that just did get me depressed at one point is that people not understanding that I'm not chasing nothing. I just want to be able to, when I give and you give, we can make shit happen.
Yeah.
If I'm only giving and you're only taking, I'm going to die and you're going to, do you know what I'm saying? That's all I want.
With energy and that when you're naturally a giver, that you attract takers.
100%.
Did you know that?
I didn't know that, but it makes sense.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
I had to learn that out the hard way.
Yeah.
So I had to literally study energy and different types of people, like who have high energy levels, people with low energy levels, and why you attract people
with low energy level
that take from you when you're naturally just a giving person. Yeah. So, you know, when you're constantly asking the question, but I'm such a giver, like I always am.
Yeah.
How comes they're like that?
Yeah.
It's all to do with energy transfer. See, I wanted to
look
like
it up
that.
Myself because it makes sense.
Yeah, you should.
It makes sense. Yeah.
We're gonna get onto the main subject of energy.
Just you two, can you stop?
Yes, we're gonna get onto the main subject of energy, like after the current affairs and all that. But yeah,
current affairs.
Yeah, let's continue with your story, though. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? Let's continue your story. So, how do you stay motivated? Like, what?
I stay motivated by just being around people that are just that. First of all, it's not always about being positive. Just about being around people though, that are transparent and just honest. I like, and but also at the same, understand that I have to just be me in it. So, I just do things. So when I don't want to chat to you, don't be offended by it. It's just that sometimes I want to be in my own space.
Mm-hmm.
So, and even though you're thinking that's not something that's gonna keep you motivated, but I just like to be a I keep motivated by being able to just be myself. Mm-hmm. So if I'm around, when I can't be myself, it's stifling to me. I feel like I'm in prison, isn't it? So it depresses, it makes me a bit sad, doesn't it? So yeah. I just try to be around people that just want to make me grow, but are also positive as well. Yeah. Even when they're negative. Because even when they're negative, that's positive to me. Because it's making me know, okay, I might need to change this, or I might need to tell you to fuck off, innit? One of the two, innit? So it's one of the two, innit?
Yeah. So what was your biggest track out of that album?
You know what? My albums have never, I've never really had no hit, but I think I've had a lot of house hits.
No, to yourself. Like, what did you have a personal favourite?
On the album?
Yeah. On the one after you left them.
I reckon probably like, This Is My Time is the song that, because
when I went
when I went to the States.
I like that one.
When I went to work with, even when I did this thing with Mos Def in the States, but I worked with Ski Beats and it's a classic, but also this guy called Ski Beats, who produced Jay-Z's Streets Are Watching and I'm Out for President to Represent Me. So when I was at New York and I met Dame Dash, like this guy, this producer, he did this track called Luchini.
This is it, what? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich, what? The Cheeky finds the sugar dance, can't quit, what? Now pop the cork and see the Vega and get lit, what?
This is it, what? Luchini pouring from the sky, this is it. Mm-hmm. It's the same sample.
This is my time, so hold the world within my head.
And I didn't realize when I met him, I was like, yeah, you know, I did this song. And I was like, yo, I sampled this song. This is one of my biggest hits. I was like, what? Me and him ended up dating for about 3 years. Bless him. It's legend. But he taught me so much about understanding, like, the way him as a producer. Do you know Currency?
Currency.
Rapper Currency.
I've heard of him.
He produced, like, Pilot Talk 1 and 2. I was there when he recorded, when he produced.
I don't know him. Huh? You get me? I ain't got his WhatsApp, but.
No, you know what? He's the kind of person that you would like, shut up. Musically, though, he's like he's his own boss. He doesn't care about what anyone else has to say. He's got his own team going on. And like his thing was called Jet Life and stuff. And I think at the time he was about to get signed with, he's about to do some collaboration with him and Dame Dash. But that record at the time, for me, because they put out Whoopsie Daisy first, but they were meant to put out This Is My Time. Mm-hmm. But because, I don't know, for some reason, the label put out the wrong song, which didn't represent me. Yeah. And if This Is My Time had come out, I think the whole story would have been different because it would have represented me in a different way. It would have made more sense with the first album and that. Mm. But This Is My Time, I reckon, for me, is this my favourite of the album.
No, I like that one still.
It's your time. It's always your time.
Yeah. So then, like, how did it get to, I don't know. I know we done a track, but I'm thinking, how far on was twice. That? Yeah, I know. I'm thinking, how far on was that when we done it to you?
That was 2015. We did that until like 5 years ago.
Okay.
And you, but do you know how you back then you was the way you are now. I loved it. So calm and you was acting so paranoid. I went to strangle him back then.
But this person, I'm like, shut up, just do this.
But you're different. And I think you understand now. Like, less is more. You don't need to worry about these people. Fuck the people that don't get it. Don't worry about these people because your magic and your energy that you've got.
Yeah.
Because even when people talk about trolls. I never used to understand when I see people like Nicki Minaj. You've got millions of followers, but you're worrying about that one person that says something negative to you. Ah, these haters. Why are you worrying about haters when you know you've got other people that are following you? Yeah. Fuck these haters. That's what they want. They want that. They want you to give them that attention. They go, oh, yeah, you're not that happy, are you? Because why would you even give a fuck what someone has to say when they don't even do what you do?
Exactly.
And that's what I used to say about you. Like, you got so many people that respected you that you was around. But you never saw, you kept focusing on the people that were trying to get at you instead of focusing on the people that were actually on your side. I think now you're in a place where you get it. There's that place you put up about your woman, I love it.
Yeah.
Because you know what, you were there and I was like, oh my God, my heart, I feel like he's grown up, yes!
Shut up,
but I was like, you get it.
Yeah, no,
understand, focus on the people that see you.
Yep.
Because there's other people they want you to dead. They want you to kill yourself. They want you to die. They want you to be in that situation.
The next split
they
for that.
They do.
Okay. They don't want you to be
crazy.
Here.
But it's like it's, so they said mad. It's like
you got my woman though.
People, she's dope. She's dope. Like when you put it up, I was like, that's a man. That's what a man does. Because you're not scared to hide. You're not hiding your woman. Like, oh, this is the person that made me get back to. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I love that. Dope. So go on, pick up a stem. Yeah,
just cool. Yeah. I don't use bug slightly, but yeah. Yeah, use bug neatly. No. Get me back.
No, I wasn't.
Cool.
I love it. And I think she's beautiful
bug
as well. Pick up yourself.
Get me. She's bug neatly. Oh, like,
God, two wishes, you know, this is what.
Let me to you, go boss. Like, get me.
See? All of this. You need, don't ever change. It's this bug, is it. Yeah. Don't ever change this. It's I love bug, it.
But it's, you get me, your piss, but you know. Nah. But flip him. So I don't know, like what? Because I see the tune with you and Frisco as well.
So you're a bad boy now, because you're moving with the bad boy crowd. Today you're going to learn a lesson. Are you a sheep or a shepherd? Say you're pro and ain't got no profession. That's shaky. Bad from the bar, nobody never trained me. Man wanna act too crazy, and when it goes down, man I like loud. If I'm on wavy, well, take it down a bit. We know you're a counterfeit.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
bad as well.
Yeah, Frisco.
I love Frisco. Big up Frisco.
Listen, original. Listen, he taught me when I met Frisco.
Bad lyricist.
Listen, one of the realest. Listen, when I was going through my little mad phases, because there's a point when I was doing a lot of strippiness, drinking, drugs. I'm gonna be honest, I was doing a lot of foolishness I shouldn't do, and I'd always be calling him, and after a while he'd be like, "Yo, what are you doing in it?" Like, but he, this is what I'm saying. When you have the real people around you, he wasn't enabling any of the foolish behavior.
Yeah.
Even having him on that record. It was such an honour for me because I know he don't do anything that he don't want to do, innit?
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
That's when I started, when he started
Sky,
doing...
Sky!
Yeah, when he started doing the den and all that, and I was like, I was there from the beginning, I was thinking, yo, and that then made me inspired to then become my own person as well when it comes to the melting pot, this thing that I have on the radio where I celebrate other people that have inspired me, that have shaped me. You might have been the post office man that come to my house and every day to post. But every time you spoke, you made me feel a certain way. So I'm talking, like, let's talk about your inspiration.
Yeah.
So... what I do on that show is, like, I get people to give me, like, their songs, the soundtrack of their lives, or the songs that meant something to them. And you talk about what, when you heard it the first time, and what it made you feel.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had Jules Holland on there, I've had Omar on there, I've had... You understand? Yeah, that's time. I'm going to have you on there as well. So just to switch out.
You should.
I have my accountant on there. Do you know what I mean? Like, the people that I've just been... I'm going to have my mum on there one day, you know what I mean? It's just people
that... would be good.
Everybody's... because everyone's important to your shit. Do you know what I mean? They said it takes a village to raise a child,
exactly.
Doesn't it?
Of course,
it's not just being famous and all this... in the mysterious cloak and dagger bullshit. There's not cloak and dagger, I always get that wrong. What's it called? Smoke and mirrors.
Smoke and mirrors.
My sister was cussing me, cloak and dagger, sorry, smoke and mirrors. But you know what I mean? So Frisco, having Frisco on there, and look how even me and you, we're so, you know, I guess even the music you make, we're so far apart of what we talk about. So I'm like, yo, I wish I could say, some of the things you said, I couldn't never. But I love it. But the thing is, what I love, the fact that you can see me and you're like, oh, look at you and you're dry, you're just only doing this positive talk. And that's the thing, it's like, it's not about us stopping each other, but it's acknowledging each other. Understand that there's different things.
Come on.
That way we can grow.
It
can
Oasis killed that the other version as well.
Which one?
The Oasis.
Remember your one, you're talking about Gunn and his one, but the thing is, by the time some people are like, are you sure? But I said, no, you know what? I have to let him be him because the whole point of Blue Twice is he's being honest with himself.
But I had to put it in.
No, of course you had to. And I loved it because I'm like, but a lot of people there, oh, we can't play that. I'm like, but whoever played it, that played it, then I don't know, obviously most people played Flo's version because it was more spiritual and it was more positive. But people have to understand, the way I've grown up in such a different, like, I've grown up in all different areas. So it's not, I can't be like, oh, now that I'm here, I can't talk about this thing. Mm-hmm. It's reality, it's real. And I asked them to be on the record for a reason.
But it was the most commercial I could ever be.
Yeah.
That's the money
thing.
That's the most commercial I could ever be.
But you spoke some truth, though.
And
you spoke your truth, and that's all I wanted.
Exactly.
That's all I wanted.
Yeah.
Listen, people, go back and listen back to Lose Twice featuring Young Spray, he's speaking some truth.
No, actually, listen to the one featuring Flo Oasis.
No, listen to the one who's speaking Young Spray.
You know what I'm saying? But we've moved on now.
Oh, yeah, because you're Big Bad Spray now, aren't you? Sorry. You're not young bad. No more. I'm big and bad.
Yeah, wicked and big and bad. Big and bad and big and bad.
You're still the same person,
big
yeah?
and bad and bad and big. You get me?
I posted something today that I did in 2003 at Jules Holland. And looking at my younger self, I had the weave and I was a bit more her. But I'm still the same me. That's still energy that's there. I was always, I'm just a bit more refined
energy.
Now. Energy keeps coming.
Been waiting to talk about energy. Go on, Cream.
No, actually,
wait. Current affairs, because you remember you said there's a couple
of things. Oh, yeah, okay, let me see.
Yeah, because energy's deep. Go on.
Energy's a lot, isn't it?
Current affairs, let's see what I've got.
Well, I've had like a really, really busy week, so I haven't actually been... on social media. Actually, I've been trying to cut down on the internet.
I think you should.
Big on energy and stuff like that. So I haven't even been scrolling as much. Mm-hmm. But I did notice, do you know M. Honcho?
Yeah, I've heard, my sister told me about this.
Oh yeah, Fastlane done the tune with him.
Because he's one of my son's favourite artists, basically.
Yeah.
And he was like telling me that, you know, he always wears a mask.
Yeah.
And he's not really into the social media. Like, he does his music and stuff, but he doesn't really have his face, or he doesn't show his face or anything.
Yeah.
So he must have been in a studio, and one of the guys that was in the studio has secretly recorded him when he took his mask off.
Yeah.
And posted it. So yeah, he went trending because trending. His face is now shown.
I ain't seen it. I mean? Have you seen it?
Yeah, I did see it.
What's he looking at? Is he butters or?
No,
I need to understand why the mask is called a thing. I don't know. I ain't seen it.
He said it because he wants to be private. Doesn't want to be.
No, but I don't. No, but I don't understand it. Do you get what I'm trying to say? If you're not a criminal,
no, he wasn't an ugly guy. No, he wasn't.
Do you get what I'm saying? I just don't know.
I was more like, that person's bad mind.
Of course.
Do you understand? Like, there's no positives. Why you're gonna post that?
Yeah.
You know he doesn't show his face. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Do you understand?
When people
he obviously that. Trusted you. Why
a,
you took it off?
Worse is a boy and not a girl.
Exactly. Mm, like,
yeah.
You're secretly posting him. Nah.
So he's Asian, right?
Yeah, I think. Yeah.
But then I think what happened, because obviously it's funny enough. My sister only, because the other day she told me, because I wouldn't have known about it otherwise. You know, just granny that I am.
Oh, did you hear about it? Yeah.
My sister told me. She's okay. Yeah, Emma. Because remember, I'm not really on the blogs and stuff.
But
like
you ain't seen it either, innit?
No, I saw it. I looked it up after because she told me. But then she said something about him using the N-word a lot and people cussing about him using the N-word, and he's Asian apparently. So.
Okay.
So that's another thing. But I think you're right. I think people. Everyone's trying to expose people these days, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just trolling. It's mad.
No, see me, yeah. Mm. Me personally, I just think like. Your favorite, like your that's you never you're yeah. obviously gonna they're gonna see your face at some point. Like the police will see your face, no matter how much crime you're gonna do, yeah.
No,
with your mask on, they're gonna still have your face. We think it's him. They're gonna have your proper face, and like so everyone. So I don't know, me personally. You see how we was really on mad smoke, like you get what I'm saying, mad smoke. Yeah. But our face was out, so. Obviously, I understand if that's what he's doing, that's his, as an artist, I get that, but,
no, but I
if
think
people
he,
know your face, safe, whatever,
but
you
I think
what I'm
he
trying
was
to say, get over it.
Apparently, he didn't want to have it, from what I can gather, it. He didn't want to show his face.
No, of course, but that's just you as an artist or whatever, but that's what you, that's just the, you've come into that life, innit?
But you know, I'll be honest with you, I agree with you, when it comes to, especially
you've
the
come
kind,
into
of,
that life.
Kind of music that he makes, in that world, like, you, I don't think you have every right, like, not every, you have a right to, obviously, your privacy, but...
I reckon that he's expected that he's, at some point his face is going to
be seen. Yeah, but when he
but, like, maybe if, like, paparazzi caught him or something,
the
fact that it was when he was in the studio, it was when he was recording with Dacciavelli.
Has he said anything about it?
And it was apparently one of his friends that released it.
Yeah, that's
bad mind. Has he said anything about it, Cream? Has he said anything about it?
I don't know.
I don't think he would care.
But he doesn't care about social... Yeah. Like, as far as what I can see from the things that he comments on and that, he always states that he doesn't really care about all of that kind of stuff.
Is he good?
So he wants to... I think he's good.
Yeah,
he's good.
I need to check him out.
He's got, like, that melodic
rap.
I do definitely think he's a vibe. I do think he's a good artist. And the fact that he's not really into it for the fame of it...
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah. He's doing it for the music. Okay.
No, I respect his thing. But guess what, though? That's what comes with the game.
That's what does
come
with
the game. That's what comes with the game.
You can't be like, oh, I don't want it. Like,
no. You're not, like, you get what I'm trying to say? You're not a girl. Like, you get what I'm trying to say?
What does that mean?
No, but I'm just trying to say it. It's like, whatever, innit? Like, okay. Like, you're not in mad beef, are you, M. Honcho? Do you get what I'm trying to say? You're not in mad beef.
Girl can be in bad beef too, though.
No, but you don't understand what I'm saying. Like, do you get what I'm trying to say? You're not dodging no major cases. You're not. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So you just push it. You just keep it pushing.
But don't you feel
you
like
keep your mask on next time you're in the studio. So a madman.
Nobody.
And that's it. Do you get what I'm saying? And you just keep it pushing.
But don't you feel like a lot of these nowadays that they kind of snitch themselves? Is it just me? Am I just...
They're doing the police's job for them on the
net. Right? Is it just me?
Definitely. I think so. Too much dry snitching.
Too much dry
no
and talking
dry
about
snitching.
Things that I think sometimes I don't even
But you know what
you
is?
Do.
See the whole dry snitches? I've been called a dry snitcher. Nobody's in jail. So it's like all the dry. I think everyone needs to understand what even snitching is and... That's just
no,
a whole different. That's a whole different conversation. You get what I'm saying?
Incriminating
yourself
and incriminating others, it can be used against you.
Yeah.
So you're doing easy work for them. They didn't even have to find out shit because you did it all for
and
them.
And then they're just waiting for you to slip up so they can go. Ah, exactly. There you go. Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean?
Oh, you don't like
this one,
isn't it?
No, I don't mind it. I just know people don't really know what they're talking about when it comes to all of that. But you get what I'm saying? Just a lot of people.
Talking. Yeah, and sometimes I think even the glorified, because I think if you come from that world, especially sometimes you don't really want necessarily everyone to know. You want to come out of it, innit? You're trying to show your kids you have to be about that. So when you keep talking about, oh yeah, I still do this and I still do that, it just makes
it's
you
the
look
energy
a bit,
as well.
Because you don't have to prove yourself until, if you're doing that, people that know need to know, they know, innit? Mm. If you have to keep talking about it,
but you know what it is as well. Exactly, that's their
the way of making themselves feel good about
them. Not even that. That's their music. Do you get what I'm saying? It's like gangster rap. That's, look at what them lot was talking. It's not nothing good, Biggie and Pac and all that. What we was listening to.
But
let's not start all acting like we're, do you get what I'm trying to say? We weren't listening to nothing good.
But remember that documentary apparently when the mum said,
I was listening to Mob Deep and all that. They were talking about bursting people. Like, so
I love gangster music. I love it,
I
even up to now.
Gangster,
yeah.
Like, I just like it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I listen to some gangster shit. So when I'm looking at, we can say whatever we're saying, but they're just listening to their gangster shit.
You never believe, look at yourself.
No, but they're just listening. You get what I'm saying to you? They're just listening to their gangster shit.
But you know what I think is funny? Because remember, you guys, you understand because we live in it.
It's just about not taking it so seriously.
But you have to know, what my problem is the people that listen to it and that don't know that some of it might not be as, like, remember, we live it, we've been around it, we've grown up around it. There's some people that, you know, when you look at half of the fans out there, most of them are white. They've never experienced anything that we've experienced. So when we're saying certain things, this is just a lifestyle for us. But for them, next minute, they believe this is something that they, then other people start emulating it, then they start making money from it and they start to box it into certain things. That's when people get pissed off when they do well for kind of glorifying it when it's actually your life, isn't it? So I think that's the reason why I think sometimes you've got to just be so careful with it. Because I think,
yeah, go on, sorry.
Do you remember that? I think there's a documentary of Biggie, and the mum says, we're talking about, we used to eat sardines for dinner.
And
the mum
was
like,
upset.
She's like, you never eat no sardines for dinner. I had food on the table. What are you talking about? So it's like, be careful, innit? Like, tell the truth, innit? Don't do this whole, because you're trying to see the
Yeah,
she's like,
she was,
how you mean?
Yeah, yeah.
And this is what I'm talking about, because it's true. When you think about most Black Caribbean households, you don't even, never have to really worry about
a feeling.
Come on.
She never find him funny.
A feeling weren't moving.
Like, how fucking dare you?
Feeney was moving like two parts.
But I guess because he wanted to kind of show the streets. See, I'm down with you. Like I don't like when people are exploiting the people that really don't know no different. I don't like that. I guess you talk to your talking shit, but then be real about it, innit? That's
yeah,
it for me.
I believe as an artist, you can tell your story, but because you don't have any like choice over where you was brought up and stuff like that. So you have to tell your story, innit?
Yeah,
through your art. But there's a difference between glorifying negativity.
Exactly.
Do you know what I mean?
So the reason that my
sister... a lot of people's negative stories have made major impact on people's lives because they use them through testimony, innit?
But if I think when it's honest and true, I rate that because I'm like, you know what? But look how you've come now. But
exactly.
When you're just using it to get...
Yeah.
I don't like that.
Yeah.
I think they're just using it as a way to vent. You get what I'm saying? Like, that's just them expressing
it.
It's
telling the truth out of mind.
We used to express, do you get what I'm trying to say? Yeah, but a lot of people weren't telling the truth in our day.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what you used to say.
A lot of people just don't tell the truth.
That's why you used to get vexed about stuff, innit? Because you know that people would lie about stuff, no?
Yeah, but, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, innit? I'm madly over it. But it's like... Yeah, like, they're just telling their story and they're just venting, innit?
Yeah.
Like, music's always been, like, my therapy, so it's their therapy as well, probably.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? True. And they're just getting some of them just getting mad with it, just getting it twisted, saying, bear mad.
Mad
stuff! Do you get what I'm saying?
Exactly.
This is what we're talking about, dry snitching, that's what we're saying, exactly.
Now.
Crazy.
No, but that's what I'm saying, that's your version of dry snitching, but... I'm not gonna get into my version. I'm not gonna get into it. I'm a dry snitch, but no one's in prison. But that's what I'm saying. We move. Do you get what I'm trying to say? We move, innit? Dry snitch.
No, but I think we need
move.
To understand
we
before
move.
We dead it, because it's gonna
be
no.
But I'm going into energy and all that. I don't wanna talk about all that. Because that's bad energy for me. You get what I'm saying? So I don't wanna
talk about it. See, I've got to respect that.
It's released.
So so boom now. Yeah, like they're just dealing with this is their error. So when you're hearing bear, stab this, stab that, stab this, stab that.
That's madness.
Because that's what's going on.
Yeah.
Like they're really, do you get what I'm saying? And it's like going
smoking
into the main subject or whatever. Yeah.
On that one
going
honest,
into the main subject, it's like, it's the energy they're getting brought up with. Like,
yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? They're on their computer or whatever.
And they see what's winning.
Call of
as well.
Duty, they're stabbing up everything. It's like what you see in it. My little research on the energy thing is like, raw. They said there's seven ways to take in energy and give out energy through your eyes, your ears, your nose and your mouth, So obviously they're watching all these things from young, yeah, computer, stabbing up everything, shooting up everything. They're listening to mad music because their elders are living mad, so they're spitting mad, innit? Mm-hmm. So they're listening to the drill. It's not their fault. They're just spitting what they're spitting. Mm-hmm. But the youths are listening to that. They're seeing all of this. So the energy they're taking in is all wrong. Mm-hmm. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Mm. Energy is important. So that's why they're going all over the place, because the energy is all wrong. So me personally, I just say to people, like, obviously our age, we got kids, innit? I got a youth that's like 13. Like, check their phones, innit? You know what I'm trying to say? You have to make sure you know what they're on. Yeah. Me as a youth, I could go to my mum and she'll think I'm heavy, like I'm a good youth, but I'm in the streets crazy. Do you get what I'm saying? I'm just smoked a crack spliff. You get what I'm saying? I'm in the yard. Moving like I'm cool, mum. No, but it's not even funny, but I'm saying check their phones.
This is why it's
check
up on
them. Check up on them. Because it's like, you'll be surprised, innit? Mm-hmm. You get what I'm trying to say? So it's like...
That's amazing.
I keep my eye on...
I think on, if you've got dude, kids, you get like, what I'm
to make sure...
Have a close relationship.
Yeah, you could check their energy, what they're taking in. Check their bridgings, right? How they're chatting to their bridgings. What type of energy are they taking in?
Yeah.
What type of energy are they giving out? You get what I'm trying to say?
Definitely.
Do you know what I mean? Because obviously we're busy. As parents, we're very busy.
Yeah, we're trying to keep it on.
Obviously, bear that in mind. Yeah, I'm trying to say that whilst you're busy, your youth could be styling you.
Exactly.
You know, because how many times it happened like, someone was like, my son was not that kind of person. You find that your son was the biggest kid in everybody.
Yeah, and they could just be styling
you. And they'd be like, look, mum, I would never. Like, no, but my son never did these things. It's like, it's true.
That's how my mum was. She used to go mad. Like, really? Why are you picking on my youth? But my mum, she wouldn't have nothing bad against me, but I'm going mad. You get what I'm saying? But I'm knowing how to deal with my mum.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So, some youths just know how to deal with you,
innit? Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? They're smart enough.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, just check up on them, innit?
I used to question my son all the time. Like, not like in a bad way. So, like, I'll just act like it's a conversation.
Yeah.
But I'm finding out stuff.
Yeah.
So I'll constantly like asking, so what did you do today? So what happened? Is it? So who are you always with? So who's like you closest? Like, you know, like, I knew all his mates.
Yeah.
Everything. So, you know, like, any little thing, I'd know where to go. Well, I thought I knew where to go, but do you know what I mean? Do you get me? But I constantly, like, used to just want to know what was going on.
Yeah.
Mm. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm.
I love that.
What's your...
I love that. I really
how do you feel about, like, energy? Because energy, to me, it's very... It's important.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? And it's like... Everything, to me, is to do with energy. That's why, obviously... Like, we've got this podcast. We even started it because obviously, like, no, I shouldn't even be doing all of this, yeah. My brothers, them go mad at me for smoking and all that and drinking, but it's like, I'm Muslim and cream is devout. Do you get what I'm saying? Christian. Do you get what I'm saying? But I'm saying, my mum was Catholic or whatever, devout or whatever. So our whole thing as well, when we even started this, is to show that everyone's just, we're just, you know what I mean? We're just the same type of thing. Yeah, obviously, like, my belief is my belief, her belief is her belief.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because she's dealing with the same belief my mum was dealing with, so.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's energy as well, because it's like, to me, obviously, I'm being nuts, like smoking and drinking and whatever. Stuff,
but the thing is, the fact that you're aware of it, you're
but I shouldn't be doing it. But yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah, it's not cool. But
when you're ready to stop, you will.
But listen, listen to me. But I'm saying, when I'm not or whatever, as far as like the deen and Islam is concerned, it keeps your energy levels at the right levels as far as energy is concerned. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because
if you don't smoke, if you do,
no. I'm just talking about following Islam. I'm just talking about following the deen. Forget all of this. This is bad energy. Do you get what I'm trying to say? But I'm just talking about following what you're supposed to be following.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're doing that, your energy is right, righteous all the way. But to me, it's like the same way, like my mum was devout or whatever, my nan, like they was devout with what they was doing and their energy was right. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So it's not necessarily about your religion to me because... Like, I believe what I believe, but it's like, same way I believe Allah knows best. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So it's like, I can't talk on a next person Do you get what I'm trying to say? Or if they're righteous because they're not Muslim, or if they're not, because I can't talk on that because Allah knows best to me. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So I can't talk like on you. So it's like,
that's the thing, it's not forcing your thing on other people. That's what I never used to like when people that used to, oh, you should this, but I see them do certain things, I'd be like, but you can't tell me how to be, you're not even practicing what you're saying yourself. So, but the thing is, as long as you're not judging anyone,
exactly. I get more criticism. Human, I get more criticism from Muslims.
Yeah, of course.
I get more, because obviously, like, I shouldn't be a certain way. I shouldn't be pushing out a certain character or whatever. But you get what I'm trying to say, which is true. Yeah, but it's like,
but you're being truthful to who you are, and I think that's how you know get to the point.
Do you know what it is? I just know that I've got to deal with my judgment, and so it's like, I just think people should concentrate on their judgment.
Yeah.
I think it would be worse if you were doing it behind closed doors. When you're doing it behind closed doors, but they're pretending that you're this first, I prefer to see that and you saying that you're doing it.
Hypocrisy is a big sin.
That's the thing. Definitely. I can't take. So that's why I would rate you more than that person. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. And I rate you more than that person that's giving you all this. Because how many people I know that be about their certain religion and behind closed doors, I know that they've been doing bare madness.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't respect you for that. Like, because it means you're not really, you know what I mean? Not giving us a real picture. You're giving us a real picture. Yes, I'm this. I know I shouldn't be doing this. Hopefully one day you'll stop doing it. Or you might not, whatever. But at least you acknowledge it.
Well, definitely.
I stopped before.
Yeah.
I stopped when I went Gambia. I came back, I went smoking. I went, you know what I'm saying? Ibs straightened me up. But
yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But just for this, obviously, this is out of my comfort zone, innit?
So it's making you feel comfortable when you're...
No, just so I'd have my little smoke, I have my little dig out. I'm saying, this ain't me. This ain't me. Huh?
You say before that? Little dig out. Oh,
no,
I just feel like life is a they say life is a journey, not a destination.
This is true.
And like when God and when Jesus was doing his works, he didn't go to the people that was already saved.
Diego.
He went to the people that was doing bad things that needed to clean up their lives.
Yeah.
And through testimony, I believe that you reach out to people even more.
Mm.
Like on the last episode, we had a guy, Marvin Herbert.
For me to go straight, I had to switch off from everybody.
Yeah.
Mm.
Now, don't get me wrong, it was lonely.
Mm.
Right? It was lonely. Right? I felt lost at times, yeah? But then I asked my daughter once, yeah? What would you do if I went back to prison? Mm. Yeah? What would you do if I went back to prison? Because they're middle class now. She was like, well, I'd never speak to you again, Daddy.
Mm.
Why would you want to go to prison? Every ethnic minority, right, that is in crime, right, now, everybody that's in crime, all the criminal families, whether they're black, white, Chinese, African, fucking whatever, it doesn't matter, right? They're all in it because they're all trapped. None of them are 100% happy. None of them are 100% set for life. And every single one of them have the opportunity to go to prison, get stabbed and get killed.
And his story is so interesting and intriguing. Yeah, big him up. Like he touches a lot of people because they can relate to him. So when you go through things, like, that in itself, like, is powerful.
100%.
And the things that come out of struggle and bad things as well, like, the most beautiful things come out of those places. Mm-hmm. And the amount of people that you can touch just by them seeing your story alone is big. So
that.
Sometimes when you're going through things, don't even beat yourself up.
Don't beat yourself up.
Do you understand what I'm saying? That's like, with me and my music, I'm just unapologetic with my music. My mum's a minister.
Is it?
Yeah, but and not a lot of people would not even, well, obviously she knows when she's praying, Lord, please help her to translate it in a cleaner way. Do you understand? She knows that.
Yeah.
But I'm on my journey.
I love that.
So who can relate to me will relate to me because I know where I'm going to go in the end. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Because you know, it's mad. Turn you to it. Watching it, when you watch your videos, because it's unapologetic to the point of like,
totally.
It's mad. And then about here, and this is why I've got respect them because it's so honest.
Yeah, they get onto her for that still. They can't believe. Yeah. They can't believe how she deals with the interviews. Because
I'm unedited and I'm not. It's amazing. Really, they can't believe it. I don't care what people think about me.
They can't believe the mind game she's dealing with.
The way I express myself in my art is the way I express it.
Yeah.
You've got like people that make movies.
Yeah.
You know, and they got drug, sex, and violence, and they're winning how many awards for this because they've done such a good movie. Like, they're not wicked people. I know where my heart is. You understand what I'm saying?
Like,
so,
you know what I'm saying? It's like, you got bad man. Like, I know a couple, you get what I'm saying? Come on. You know what I mean? Like, some serious guys. But on the other side, man will be taking the youths to go swimming and...
Yeah, yeah.
where, do you get what I'm saying? The other side of that, with good comes evil. So the other side
this
of that is...
It's a balance. It has to be a balance. Because how are you supposed to understand it? How are you going to be like, no, like, you've never experienced it. You have to experience it to understand what you're dealing with.
It's just simple, like, good over evil.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? Always. With good comes evil, but then good over evil. Yeah. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Make sure you do more good than bad. Do you get what I'm trying to say? And learn that... that what goes around really comes around.
I believe in karma so much and energy. Trust me.
Yeah.
I feel, trust me, even if I find a pound on the street, I'm thinking, if no one's seen, okay, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like you've always got to just be honest about what you do. Like, and just always realise there's consequences of everything that you do in life.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
Like, when you said earlier on about the numbers don't lie, like, I believe, like, there's certain quotes that are put out there to actually confuse you.
Yes.
Like, when that thing about sticks and stones may hurt, but words will never hurt me. That is one of the biggest lies out there because there's life and death in the power of the tongue.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying? So
powerful.
You've got to be careful about things that you know that are taught to you from young.
Yeah.
To keep you not focused. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Because we were talking about this earlier about trolls, like, they fascinate us, and people that can be, and you find out, I think there's this woman that she was trolling someone, and they found out who she was, and she was like some 50-year-old woman that was just cussing people online, and then she ended up killing herself because they found out who she was. Because she was just trying to make other people feel shit about themselves because of how she felt about herself.
And look, one day of people knowing who she was, she
couldn't handle it. But you was on there constantly.
You was on somebody else's, exactly.
Mad. But I even think to myself, why would you? Because I have this thing, if you have got nothing good to say, don't say nothing at all, innit? Like, one of those things. Yeah. But it's like, I never understand people that want to go out of their way to say something evil to make someone feel bad about themselves. I find that in itself as a
they got a problem with their self.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely. Wicked.
You know, they got a problem with their self.
Because
it's like,
bad.
I can't, like I said, innit? I can't see something mad and actually write that it's mad. I'll just say, oh, that's shit. You know what I'm saying?
No, you do. You like to call,
but I don't say that shit. I just have jokes in it, like, grow your hair or something.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? but grow your hair. It's like her followers, because I wind up her followers. That's all I do. Because I follow, she's got rainbow, them man that wear rainbow slippers, following her, they can't believe I'm telling her to grow her hair.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I saw you got into it.
Like,
you
say madness now. You say madness in a rainbow way. Do you get what I'm saying?
In a rainbow way,
you say madness. Do you get what I'm saying?
Let my rainbow people alone.
But that's what I'm saying. But he's not knowing me and her know each other. We're just joking. You don't even know her. You're not mental. You're just a mad follower.
Piss off. Exactly.
Do you get what I'm saying? You're just a mad follower. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Going mad. You get what I'm
saying?
That's
actually something that I know actually.
But knowing him's mad anyway. You get what I'm saying? Knowing him's crazy. Take that back.
Oh my gosh.
But nah, do you get what I'm saying? We have jokes. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, should we,
But
this is long. This is long now.
But that's the balance.
I'm saying, when I saw it, it weren't even like that.
I shaved it off. It was.
Mm.
But the day I did that, babe, is when I saw myself. Because I used to date people and I'd be like, oh, if I shaved my head, how would you feel? Like, no, you look like a lesbian. No.
I love the short haircuts.
Listen, when I shaved it off, like for me, I had to do it more for myself. Because at one point, my hair wasn't growing right. And I was like, no, I can't be held hostage by this. Like, I'm not allowing my hair to hold me hostage. So I shaved it off and I was like, whoa, like, it was one of my favorite hairstyles. But now I'm growing it back. I'm going to go back into Afro. But I think once you allow yourself to let go of things, nothing can stop you. And nothing can hold you hostage.
No, definitely.
If you keep I feel like, I think so. Because when you cut your hair and still feel confident, that's big.
Yeah.
Because I cut my hair off from when I was young.
You know, she's just thinking, oh, shut up, spray.
No, but I know,
getting emotional. She's whatever.
But I know him. And exactly. The thing is, this is the thing about balance. You have to understand. You get offended when you don't understand what someone else from the other side. And like, I know why he thinks the way that he thinks. I've dated guys like you. They're like, lady, like a lesbian. No, you can't do that. You need to have hair. No, you need to be wearing this type of thing. I'm like, listen, I'm doing what I'm doing in it. Whatever, get over it in it. And that's the thing. So I'm like, I'll shut up. But someone else that doesn't know that, oh my gosh, she's gonna feel insecure. No, I don't feel it. I love the fact that he can say, I want you to be able to say how you feel.
Listen. If you know me, you know that's what I do. Say that's 100%. I'll tell you when it's time to go gym, everything. Yeah. Do you get what I'm saying?
Time to go gym.
No, but I don't know. There's something wrong with me. Do you get what I'm saying? I've got a problem, innit?
No, but but the thing is, because of the way you look after yourself, that's why. Because it's a certain standard. When you have a certain standard for yourself, you want the people that are around you to have the same standards for themselves. That's it.
Yeah.
Because that's how you are. You can tell you go gym, you look after yourself.
Nah, I ain't been gym for a bit, you know.
But you've naturally got a certain physique about you, so you're
I don't know, man. That's
take a compliment. I'll give you a compliment.
Nah, respect, respect. That's prison, though. Anyone that knows me from school knows, nah, that's skinny Leon.
Yeah.
Yeah, skinny.
It's Leon, yeah.
Skinny you, huh?
Is it Leon?
Leon.
Leon.
Lay on. Yeah, lay on.
Lay on.
So what was it like? Like in the with the females in the scene, like when you was, you know, back in the day.
See, that's the thing. Me and females, and this is the thing. Like, as much as I'm a very tomboyish, and me and my guys, I'm all for my females all day long, and I'm the one that's always encouraging everybody. I think there's some females that sometimes that would never understand that I don't give a fuck about certain things. I'm not a girly girl. Mm. I'm not the one that's gonna, like, when I have a point when I have to weave and the eyelashes and everything else. But I realise the maintaining, I'm just not as, see, like how you're just slick with it.
Mm.
It's slick. It's all, I'm like, the eyelash will be up here. And then to the point, I'm like, you know what, let me just be natural shmee and it works. So sometimes those females sometimes would never understand why I don't want to be that way.
Mm-hmm.
And they look at me and be like, oh, but she's not serious, isn't it? But then anyone that understands and knows me, like, you can come see on. It. This is who I am, isn't it?
Mm.
But me and I love my females more than I love my brother. I love my brothers, but my females, because I want you to understand that without all of that, you're beautiful regardless. Like, wherever you can run anything that you want to run, isn't it? It doesn't matter. You don't have to be sexual, you don't have to be whatever, but you can just be yourself.
Come on.
So I can be sexual, but I can also be tomboyish, and I'm still running shit, innit? Exactly. This is my point. Yeah. That's what I want them to know. So you have everything. You're running the world, yeah? Yeah.
Yeah, no, definitely, man. But yeah, energy, very serious.
Very serious.
Very serious.
I think that's why we're here today. Like, imagine if when you asked me to do it, you know, and I was like, of course. But then at first I didn't realise that you were doing it together. And then when I looked, I was like, oh, even better.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember, obviously, no, because I would have done, no, it was great to do it with you anyway, but it's nice to have a female's
perspective. Even better. Don't piss me off.
Female's perspective.
Cupboard.
We're the most.
We know RTM. But what's nice is, as I said, because I knew about you from before I even knew about you. But then, before I even saw your videos and stuff, I'm like, and I'm thinking, I'm just going to be interested to see how we connect. Because I'm so, from a young person, I always be like, good love, everybody. We're all African. We're all black. We're all one. You know, but that's me.
Yeah.
And my cousin be like, oh, shut up. No one wants to hear that right now. We want to hear badness, innit? But then, and I've realised that is my friend.
You've always been lovely.
I've always been that person. I'm always like, oh no, but you're beautiful. And I'm like, oh, shut up. No one wants to fucking hear that right now. That's what it is. But I know that your music is like, listen, motherfuckers, da 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 da. But then, yet, this energy, I'm like, this is it. Because that's what I've grown up around.
Mm-hmm.
Real boss bitches, you know. Not little bitches, but real boss queens. You know what I'm saying? But we're still human beings, innit?
Like,
we still have feelings. We still hurt. We're still human at the end of the day.
Exactly.
And that's what's nice about being able to sit here and talk to both of you. And this one as well. You know this one already. It doesn't let nothing slide, innit? He just knows everything. No. Which is good.
I'm slightly high, but...
No, today, but I'm not usually, like, you're someone that's very, you know, no, don't see
the,
no bullshit.
Yeah, I'm on the ball.
No, you're not, though. I think you just don't like, you call out the bullshit, innit?
Competition last time, innit? So it was like, what was track 10 on Hard to Kill Volume 1? But I always get the guests to pick it. I know, I'm mad.
He's got his bag.
Yeah, madness.
Oh!
Yeah, just pick one.
I'm looking for, like, what is this coming out of here? Like, what the hell is this?
Don't worry about that, man. J-Lasty. We're reusing them and all that.
At @Addy_A36.
See it there.
Well done.
At @Addy_A36.
I'm like, what the hell is pulling out this piece of bag?
Follow RTM Podcast Show and RTM Clothing Original. And send your address and that. And we've got the shirt for you. But yeah, just wanted to... Every episode, I give them a book to go and read, innit?
Oh, nice.
So, this episode, the book is by Tupac Shakur.
Yeah.
The Rose That Grew From the Concrete.
I love Tupac. It's one of my favourites.
Have you read this?
No, one more now.
Basically, Bear, he's got Bear...
Oh, so actually he's like
poems. Yeah, Bear poems.
That's dope.
Bear
That's
poems.
All his poems?
Yeah, allegedly. But yeah, I should think so. But yeah, all these poems.
You know, one thing I loved about him again is that whole the balance. Because he'd be like, listen, was that the one of Keep Your Head Up, You?
Yeah. Yeah.
One of my favorites.
Mad Man.
Yeah, come on. But then I used to love Bender's Got a Baby.
One minute he's
as well.
Saying madness, next minute he's talking about Keep Your Head Up.
But it's like if you, even when Lauren said, you know, Lauren is only human. I think I haven't been through the same predicament in
Lauren,
lies.
Lauren is
them two people for me because they own their shit.
Exactly.
Now, Lauren Hill is the wickedest.
The wickedest, yeah, right? Yeah. The best.
Come wickedest. On. See, so the miss, see the Miseducation. Oh, yeah. That was my album in jail, you know.
That was my Bible.
That was my album in jail.
Them two, for me, because they live the life of that. They don't hide, they don't pretend. No. And that's what I got over. I don't like people give you, only show you what they want you to see. I don't like them type of people. I want you to show me who you really are so I can then go, you know what, I've actually relate to this so I can go from it. I know that I can even go from it. So. Mm-hmm. Then I'm definitely going to check that out. That's
no, check this out. I'm looking for one poem he done, but it's sick still. This one. The rose that grew from the concrete. Did you hear about the rose that grew from a crack in the concrete? Proving nature's laws wrong. It learned to walk without having feet. Funny it seems, but by keeping its dreams, it learned to breathe fresh air. Long live the rose that grew from concrete when no one else even cared. You know what I'm saying?
Powerful.
That's by Tupac. You know what I'm saying? The rose that grew from the concrete. But yeah, he's got bare sick poems in there, though.
Wow. You know what I'm saying? I love the fact that he actually got his handwriting and everything on there. Yeah. Oh, that's dope. I'm definitely
his favourite artist.
So you don't think it's his hit? Oh, Jada?
I don't know. But acting like it.
Well, if you can see, if you look at it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They're acting like it is. Sick book, though.
How old is this? This is old.
Bare sick poems.
How old is this book?
Fuck knows, man.
You're
asking me too much. My mom's trying to move like a proper horse. You're asking me other stuff.
No, but sometimes
like,
I'm
just go and read the book, man.
I'm always like this. One always said to me, ask a damn question. Just
go
take
and
the
read
thing.
The book, I'll shut serious up. Book. No, seriously, though. Let me tell them. Tupac Shakur. The rose that grew from the concrete.
The rose that
this one. Go and check that out, man.
I'm going to check it out.
Because who would you say out of Tupac and Biggie? You?
Tupac.
What about you?
Yeah, for me, Tupac.
It was always Tupac for me. Yeah.
And I think also just watching him perform, his messages, the
how
fact
he
that he
spoke,
was, how
his
he
interviews.
Spoke.
This world is such a, and when I say this world, I mean it. I don't mean in an ideal sense. I mean in every day, every little thing you do. It's such a, gimme, gimme, gimme. Everybody back off. You know, everybody's like, you taught that from school, everywhere. Big business. If you want to be successful, you want to be like Trump, gimme, gimme, gimme. Push, 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 push. Step, step, step. Crush, crush, crush. That's how it all is. And it's like, nobody ever stopped. Just, you know, I feel like, instead of us just being like, slavery's bad, slavery's there. Bad whitey, bad whitey. I mean, all right, let's stop that. And everybody's smart enough to know that, I mean, we've been slighted. And we want ours. And I don't mean by, like, ours, 40 acres and a mule, because we're past that. But we need help. I mean, for us to be on our own 2 feet, us meaning youth or us meaning black people, whatever you want to take it for us to be on our own 2 feet, we do need help. Because we have been here. We have been a good friend. If you want to make it a relationship type thing, we have been there. And now we deserve our payback. It's like you got a friend that you don't never look out for. You know, you dressed up in jewels. Now America's got jewels and they paid and everything. And they lending money to everybody except us.
Everything, even the way he acted in his movie, everything.
And
I
he
just,
wasn't
like,
scared
just,
to just be wrong and right. And like, I love people that are bold like that. Was me.
Yeah,
Biggie, yeah, no. Music wise, of course, in the
Biggie
club.
For flows and that.
Oh,
yeah,
then
obviously.
Biggie for flows and
stuff. But
Tupac.
I really.
Tupac is real.
Like, yeah.
Tupac is a real one.
Yeah, I'm saying.
From what we know, innit? Like,
I
have
posters of Tupac on my wall.
I love
beautiful
them.
Man.
Now Tupac was hard, so I'm not too sure, but I swear he done ballet or something. That's a bit crazy,
but
I don't know. That's a bit
didn't
crazy.
Did he go to art school or something?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah.
I just, he was a dancer. I ain't done ballet, innit?
No, that's
but I read Tupac.
That's Mob Deep. That's the Mob Deep guy. That you're
I don't know. I just don't know. I just don't know, but England, innit? We're different.
But that shows you, though, again, that there's no rules in this, innit?
Yeah, we're different.
It's one of the hardest.
Mm-hmm.
Hard, still. Rating.
One of the hardest.
Rating.
Okay, now I'm going to check this out. Concrete.
His energy was serious as well, but he had a very strong energy. But what was you saying about energy as well? Remember you were saying earlier
about
strong energies and all that? Yeah. They can't be around low.
No,
I was just like saying about you've got to protect your energy.
Oh, honey.
And a big thing is be very aware of the energy that you put into, that you
give out.
No, yeah, that you give out, but also before you go to sleep as well.
Really?
Yeah, like the things that you watch, things that you're listening to just before you go to sleep, things that are good for clearing your energy is like listening, saying your affirmations when you get up and when you go to sleep. Also, like big energy suckers, yeah, that bind your energy a lot. So like if you get people, like if you wake up, well, if you're a person that wakes up in the morning and then you find out like that all of a sudden you get tired and stuff like that and you can't finish things and things like that, that you normally have got energy that's binded up. So like I've got like a list of things, yeah?
Yeah.
So unreleased and unforgiven past issues. Those things replay in your head and things like that. You've got to learn how to release those things. Unfinished tasks. Open your letters, get things done. If you've got things, what you need to do, because they will constantly play in your mind, so they waste your energy.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And one of the biggest things as well, like worrying about the future.
Yeah.
Because anything that takes you away from your here and now, that's where your power lies. So anything that takes you away from your here and now, those things, they bind your energy.
Yeah.
Broken agreements.
Oh.
If you make an agreement with somebody and you break it without the consent of someone, you've made an energy bond with that person when you made an agreement.
Yeah.
So to balance out your energy levels, you either need to apologize to that person to balance it out and things like that. So the way you live your life affects your energy level. So when you come across a high energy level person and they're coming at you with all this high energy, it actually causes resentment. So you must learn about energy and how to protect your energy, how to improve it. Yeah. I won't go into too much because I'm so big into it.
As well.
It. Now you can control it as well.
Yeah, you should tell them about that.
Yeah, you can control your energy as well, you know, because obviously, well, from what I looked into, it's like I said, the seven highways for controlling your energy or whatever. There's seven ways you can take in energy and give out energy. Your eyes, your ears, your nose, and your mouth. So obviously, things you eat and all that, you know what I mean?
Yep.
I need to kind of fix up on that because I just eat whatever in it. Yeah. But as long as it's halal, but I still, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I need to fix up on that. But yeah, things you see, like, you know what I mean? Like, you have to be careful of what you're taking in. Mm-hmm. What you're listening to, you know, that deals with your energy as well. Mm. You know what I mean? Whether it raises it or it takes it down.
Yeah.
Like, always remember that you're in control of your reaction in it as well. Yes.
There you go. What I mean?
So it's like...
Big.
You're in control of it.
Yeah.
So it's like, you react how you want to react. Do you know what I mean? And make sure you keep your energy right.
Yeah. Mm.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because once your energy's right, nothing can't go wrong.
Do you know, it's funny you say that. So because the other day, I realised I used to always kind of get triggered by people.
Mm-hmm.
And I realised when I was like, I realised it wasn't about me. I was like, this isn't about me. So I was calm. And the person got offended at the fact that I was calm. They wanted me to be like, oh, what's your problem? Like, no, but I'm not mad. Like, it's cool. I see that's how you're feeling, but I get it. So what's the problem here? And they didn't like it. Mm-hmm. Or even people, like, as you said, when I'm just naturally high and I realise I'm getting absorbed by their negative or their down energy. And I'm like, how comes I've become this person? Because as I said, I'm naturally loud in your face, like, I'm always hitting you. You know what I mean? That's the kind of person that I am. But when I've become very, like, reclusive myself, I'm like, there's something not right here. So you're right. It's just so, everything you're saying this now, I'm going to look it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
And be careful as well, because sometimes you get energy mixed up, because it's like, some people might come around, man, and then think, oh, yeah, he's got bad energy or whatever.
Yeah.
But they might mix up being scared with bad energy.
That's
you
true.
Get what I'm trying to say? If you come around, man,
mm-hmm.
and you're nervous or whatever, because man's got a big aura or a heavy vibe or a heavy spirit, you're nervous, whatever.
Yeah.
Not even just man, but I'm saying, like, when you come around people, you have to be careful, innit? Like, don't just think, oh, yeah, bad energy, because it might not even be bad energy.
Nope, not at
all. You know what I'm trying to say? It's just, you're just scared of that energy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because you're not used to that energy.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? You don't understand that energy. You don't understand that energy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That energy is too major.
It's too much for you.
Yeah, that energy is too major. So you're thinking it's bad energy. It's not bad energy. It's just too major.
Yeah, it's too major.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because like how we're cool. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Yeah. I go around people and we're cool because the energy is cool. Your energy is cool. And, do you get what I'm trying to say? It's energy. Cool. But do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
It is cool.
Another big thing is like pay attention to what you pay attention to.
Yes.
Because what you give your attention to is what uses up your energy.
Yes.
And what you pay attention to is what you manifest into your life.
Mm. Yes.
So when you desire something, like if you've got a strong desire for,
pay attention to it.
It's equals to like a strong lack of. Because if you desire something, you're like an addict. Mm. So as soon as you get it, you're going to want it again.
Again, yeah.
Then you're going to want it again.
Yeah, yeah.
So you have to learn how to release things. Because when you learn how to release things and like put it somewhere, like store it and something, when you focus on it in a certain way, you manifest it into your life. So you just have to find out on ways of how to manifest the right things in and release the negative stuff out. Do you know what I mean?
Dr. Ice
But Cream. there's a book, Frederick Dodson, I think, like The Levels of Energy.
Mm.
That's a good one as well.
Forget that book for this episode still. I'm going to tell you the same thing I said to Marv still, because I went too crazy on Marv again. Forget that book still. Yeah. Big up Marv though, big brother. Mm. But flipping.
Mm. I love that, because everything you said is true. Because I felt everything that you said, I've actually felt and I've actually experienced it. So I'm like, this makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
Yeah, but my whole thing obviously would be prayer, innit? Prayer.
Prayer above all.
It's like, like when they say prayer is between you and God. Yeah. You know what I'm trying to say? Meditation is between you and yourself.
Mm.
You get me? That's deluxe still.
Yeah. So do you have to go to church to be, because I'm not religious. I believe in a higher power and I believe in the spirit, but I haven't necessarily got a religion itself.
So they say anywhere where more than three people come together and praise a church anyway. Church. But
stuff.
But what I will say is this:
put that out there.
Cut. It starts with your relationship. It starts with.
No.
What did you say?
Go on. No. Cream.
That's what I believe.
Yeah.
That's what Christians believe.
Yeah.
Christians means to be Christ-like. Yeah.
Okay.
It starts with you having a relationship with God.
Relationship.
Normally, when you want to find yourself and stuff, you ask yourself the question. I would say starting like that.
Okay.
You speak to him.
Yeah.
It will all start making sense. Learn your Bible.
Yeah.
Like you said, with energy, sometimes just pick it up and open it.
Yeah.
Your energy will even bring you to what you need to read. Yeah. Do you understand what I'm saying? But anybody can go to church and sit there. They can go every week. That don't mean they're a Christian.
There's
people that are at home that's got a stronger connection. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're in lockdown, the churches are shut. Does that mean there's going to be no Christians?
Yeah.
No, you still pray, you still have your connection, do you understand? Yeah. So my thing is learn to speak to
him.
That's
what I've always heard, said, it's a relationship.
It's a relationship. So that's why with me, like I just trust my process because I know my relationship and I know my energy.
Yeah.
So even like people's perception where they may have of me, I'm hardly ever fazed because I know 9 times out of 10 when they come around me,
they're gonna
be like, "Oh my god, you're so cool." Yeah. Unless they've got low energy levels and they've got their shit that's fucked up, then our energy will clash. Yeah, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah,
love this episode. It's so I love that. That's it.
This episode is so heavy. It's so heavy that it's finished now. God, so quick. It's God, you get what I'm saying? Wow. No, but seriously though, all jokes aside, energy.
Energy! Energy.
And I loved your energy.
Even though you're quiet, I said not much, but you're there.
keep energy in mind, man. You know what I mean? Keep energy in mind. Just try and do good more than you do bad.
100%.
Yes. You know what I mean?
100%.
You know what I mean? Try and not be a hypocrite.
That's the thing for me. I can't. I beat myself up when I'm a hypocrite, but I can't be a hypocrite. I can't lie, like, to the point I can't lie. It actually makes me feel like, ugh.
Yeah.
I have to tell the truth. Definitely. That always gets me in trouble, though, because a lot of people don't want to hear the truth.
Boy, I'm tired of going.
Follow the cream. Man said the cream, you know.
Yeah, cream.
Dollar bill, y'all.
Ice cream.
the poster girl, at big_bad_spray.
At I am Terry Walker.
At I am Terry Walker.
Yes.
Who is the Empress?
Come on, the queen.
Who deserves her flowers?
Yes.
Thank you for having me, guys. It's been lovely, seriously.
Done though.